Assalamu alaikum dear students, I welcome you to the grade 8 e-learning session week 6. I'm your mathematics teacher. This is lesson number 1 of unit number 2. In this lesson we will discuss the squares of numbers. Let's start with the definition of squares. In this topic we will study how can we find the squares of natural numbers. If we are given a natural number and we need to find the square of that number, we multiply this number by itself, then we get the square of the number. Some of the examples are given here with 1 For this, we have some conditions. If a number ends in 1, 4, 5, 6, 9 or 0, 0, that is the even number of zeros, we say that it is a perfect square. If we do prime factorization of a number and we get these factors in pairs, we say that it is a perfect square. If we do digital summation of a number and we get numbers 1, 4, 7 or 9, we say that it is a perfect square. Now, what is digital summation? In digital summation, you keep on adding all the digits of a number till you get a single number. If the sum is more than 9, we add digits again to get a single number. If this summation is 1, 4, 7 or 9, then it is a perfect square. If we are given a number and we have to conclude that this number cannot be a perfect square, we have some conditions. If the digits at ones place of a number are 2, 3, 7 or 8, then it is not a perfect square. If a number ends in odd numbers of zeros, then it is also not a perfect square. If the digital summation of a number is 2, 3, 5, 6 or 8, then it is not a perfect square. If the prime factors of a number are not in pairs, then we say that the number is not a perfect square. We will solve exercise 2B in the next video.
Assalamu alaikum dear students, may Allah bless you with knowledge, faith and good health. Welcome you to the grade 8 e-learning session week 6. I'm your mathematics teacher. Today we will start exercise 2B. So in question number 1, we have stated whether the following statements are true or false. In part A, the square of an odd number is always odd. Thus, this is true because every odd number has a square, again an odd number. For an example, 3 is an odd number and if we take the square of 3, we have 9, and 9 is again an odd number. So, this is true. In part B, the square of an even number may be odd. This is false because the square of every even number is again an even number. For example, the square of 2 is 4, the square of 4 is 16. So, this is false. In part C, the square of a negative number may be positive or negative. It is false because the square of negative number or positive number, we get a positive number. So it is false. Party, the square of every number is always positive, correct? So this is true. In part E, if a number is a perfect square, its prime factors can be grouped in pairs. This is true because if we take the prime factorization of any number, we get the pairs of numbers. So this is the true answer. In question number 2, we have to show that 3650 is not a perfect square. We solve this question by two methods. The first one is by prime factorization and the second one is by digital summation. So by prime factorization, we factorize 3650. First we divide it by 2, we get 1825. Then we divide this number by 5, we get 365. Again we divide this by 5, we get 73. And then 73, we get 1. We see that 3650 is equal to 2 into 5 into 5 into 73. So the factors are not in pairs. We have only one pair. There is no pair of 2 and 73. So we say that it is not a perfect square. In digital summation, we see that 3650, we add all the digits in 3650, 3 plus 6 plus 5 plus 0, which is equal to 14. And we know that 14 is greater than 9, so we again add it, we again get the summation. So summation of 1 plus 4 is equal to 5. We know that if a digital summation of a number is 2, 3, 5, 6 or 8, then it is not a perfect square. So we conclude that 3650 is not a perfect square. In question number 3, we have to find the squares of 132 and 528. So first we find the square of 132. We know that the square of any number is the multiplication of that number with itself. So 132 square is equal to 132 into 132. So we multiply 132 with 132. We get, with the multiplication, we get 17424, which is the answer. Similarly, 528, the square of 528 is 528 into 528. So we multiply 528 with 528 and we get the multiplication of answer 278784. Thank you.